Hello, my name is Quentin Pedroia, and today we're going to be talking about secure deployments on AKS. Microsoft Defender for Cloud is a tool for security posture management and threat protection. This tool has many plans, and one of them is for containers. This is called Microsoft Defender for Containers, and it is the cloud-native solution for container security. Defender for Containers will help you enable Azure policies to secure your cluster. You can apply and enforce built-in security policies on your cluster using the policies that Defender recommends. Azure Policy helps to enforce organizational standards and to assess compliance at scale. In this demo, we're going to be enabling an Azure Policy through Microsoft Defender for Containers. We're then going to check that that policy is correctly set up, and we're going to test that policy with GitHub Actions. One deployment will pass and one deployment will fail. Now let's get into the demo. So starting off in our AKS cluster, the first thing that we have to do is make sure that Microsoft Defender for Cloud is turned on. So we can go to Microsoft Defender and click the Getting Started tab. Once on the Getting Started tab, we can click our subscription and make sure that it's turned on. So as we can see here, I already have it turned on for containers. If you didn't have it turned on at this point, all you'd have to do is toggle the switch and click Save. Now we can double check that it's turned on by going to the Security tab in our AKS cluster. As you can see here, it says on in bold font. So now we can go to the Recommendation tab and look at vulnerabilities that we should fix. So we're going to first sort the resource type by Kubernetes service. This allows us to just quickly glance at exactly Kubernetes focused areas of improvement. So we click Kubernetes service and let's see what pops up. As you can see, remediate vulnerabilities is at the top of the list, and one that stands out to us is container images should be deployed from trusted registries only. So the first thing you can do here is deny at the subscription level. So if you click that deny option, you can pick the subscription that you would wish to deny on. So we already have that set up with our Compute PM subscription. So now let's actually just create the policy definition. So what we're going to do is we're going to make sure that our policy follows a certain standard. And this is that if anything outside of our specific registry that we want, it will be denied. So we're setting that up right now, and we're going to make sure that we set the scope properly. We're going to pick our subscription, and then we're going to pick our resource group. And just like that, we now have a policy set up. So now it takes around 30 minutes to set in, so let's give it some time and we'll come back soon. So now that the 30 minutes has passed, we can go and double check to see if that policy is actually set up. By going to our AKS cluster and clicking the Policy tab, we can quickly go to Azure Policy and check our policies that are active. So once here, we scroll down and we can see right here that was the policy that we created. Before we start deploying workloads, we can just double check to see if everything's correct. So as you can see, that assignment's there. And if we go into it, we should see that regex command that we put in. So overall, everything looks really good. So now let's start testing deploying workloads to our cluster. So now let's kick off our workloads. So we have a test repo here. And if we go to the GitHub action section, we have two actions set up. One is deploying an Nginx container that uses an ACR, and another is deploying an Nginx container that's using an MCR. So if you remember, our policy states that anything that's not using our specified ACR will be denied. So let's test this action right now, the one using the MCR, and let's see what happens. So it looks like the build and deploy is kicked off. Let's watch all the steps happen live and see where exactly this error occurs. So it looks like the red X has popped up. We can check out what the error is. As you can see, it looks like the error is a rollout status error. We can then go to the AKS cluster and see exactly what happened. So it looks like there's an error with our Nginx container. We can go into the container and see exactly what the problem is. So by going to the replica sets, we can then go into events and see what the error is. So it looks like the request was denied. If we scroll down, we should be able to get a bit more information. And if you look here, we can see that the request was denied and that the container image that uses the MCR has not been allowed. So it looks like our policy worked. The next thing we can do is test it with the ACR. So let's just clean up these resources and try that other GitHub action. So now we can go back to our repo, back to the action section, and try the ACR action. Now this should work, because again, if you remember, we stated that in our regex for our policy that anything with our ACR will be valid and will be able to be deployed. So let's kick off this action and see what happens. So the action has now been kicked off. We can sit back and wait for the Nginx container to be deployed onto our AKS cluster. So we now have the green check mark, so we should be good. If we go back to our AKS cluster and go to the workload section, we should see our Nginx container. So now we can just double check our events and our logs to make sure that everything is deployed properly. As you can see, everything looks like it's running. If we go to events, we can see that we have the scaled up replica set. So everything looks good. If we go to services, we can see that our services is up as well. We can go back into our container and go to the replica sets and check out the events as well, just to see a bigger picture of exactly what happened. As you can see, everything was successful and our policy works. In summary, what we did in this demo was enable Microsoft Defender for containers. We created an Azure policy that allowed us to only use images from a trusted source, and then we tested that policy with GitHub Actions. If you'd like to learn more about Microsoft Defender for containers, Azure policy, and GitHub Actions, please feel free to check out the links below.